to see, what to rent, and what to skip. It's Movie Reviews with Ryan J.
That's right. We are thrilled to be back with our favorite film critic, Ryan J., who's got all the connections to get you in the movies for free. Welcome back, Ryan.
It's Molly's birthday.
It's Molly's birthday.
Yay. I'm so excited to be here on your birthday show.
Thank you. I'm excited to have you here. You look awesome,
as
usual.
You. I love you.
It was so cute. I love you, too.
No, I love
Just
you.
Just go on and on.
I love you. I mean it.
It's so cute because our intern, Amanda, today was like, I can't wait to see Ryan and what he's wearing today. Uh-huh. She thinks you're so stylish.
Yes.
Thanks, Amanda.
I'm loving
Amanda's adorable. That girl
is
adorable. She's going places.
Now she's your new favorite intern ever.
Yes, yes.
Okay, let's break down the movies for this weekend because Molly's going to need something to do on Sunday when she's hungover. Now You See Me Too, PG-13.
Right, and this one is a sequel, obviously, and I did not like the first one. I said skip it.
Yeah.
But I'm happy to say that this one is better. It's good. It's good, not great,
okay.
But it's much stronger than the first one.
I can't imagine hearing you say don't see the first one than the sequel. You like better. But
yeah.
That's kind of cool. Okay, so tell us a little bit about this.
Well, it's this like sort of heist magical thriller. And what I really enjoyed about this time around is they brought on board Daniel Radcliffe as the villain.
Is that why you like it?
Stop it. What are you trying to do? What, me and my biases? Look, there are three Wizard of Oz references in this film.
Uh-huh.
But I do. Harry Potter, you know, he was great as Harry Potter, but he plays a different kind of magician here. And it's really cool to see what he does. And I really enjoyed him. There's also great chemistry among this entire ensemble.
Yeah, we see some of it.
Okay, let's talk about the number one guy in this movie, though.
Your Hollywood husband, Mark Ruffalo?
Yes.
Yeah, he's great.
Love him.
Yeah, you do love
him.
He's great.
Oh, he's so cute.
And he has some great action sequences. The effects are really cool in this movie. They have this like intricate choreography with these playing cards in this one scene and some other things. Like, it's just so neat to watch. But I love that Isla Fisher is gone, and now we have Lizzie Kaplan. She's so sarcastic and witty and funny and a scene stealer. So a really great cast.
I gotta say, visually, it kind of looks a little Ocean's 11.
Yeah, it is. It's very atmospheric, mm-hmm. and the score and the style all kind of adds to what, you know, is happening with this thriller here and really makes you feel a sense of, you know, suspense.
You good feel a climax.
You do. The climax is fantastic, but I have to tell
you. Did you hear her voice with that?
I don't know what she's doing. What are you trying to do?
I don't know.
I was just trying to ask a question.
Are you trying to get some phone numbers from
just
the audience?
Just wondering. 414-799.
All right. They're all Molly, by the way. It's Molly and David, so good luck. Basically, I think that, you know, there's some plot holes in this movie. There are some continuity problems between this movie and the first one and within this movie. So it's still see it.
Really?
But just forgive those things. Like, just shut up and watch the movie.
Just
because
have
fun. If you want to talk about it afterward, you're going to be angry.
You're so bossy.
I'm here to tell you what to do, right?
Yes,
I guess you are.
And you did it.
I finally realized why I'm here.
Yes.
Okay.
Everybody needs a
Glad
purpose.
Glad you figured that out.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
All right, The Conjuring. This is The Conjuring 2 rated R.
I'm not going
to
see it. No matter what you say.
You're going to see this
No way.
Scary?
This is my new favorite horror film
That's
ever.
Why I'm not seeing it, because you only like things that scare
Wait
you.
Wait a minute. This scared me so much, I almost cried. Fear tears.
Yeah.
I've never experienced
fear
that before.
Tears.
Fear tears. Not happy tears. Not sad tears. Fear tears. I didn't know it was a thing.
Start hashtag.
I didn't make
you
it
just
up.
Made it
hashtag
up.
Fear tears.
That
it's
is gonna
so
go,
scary.
That comment,
Tell
that
me.
Expression is going to go viral.
But here's the thing about The Conjuring 2. It is so exquisitely made. It is shot like an Oscar-caliber movie that just happens to be bone-chillingly
Icky.
Frightening.
I don't like it already.
It is gorgeous.
What about the opening scene?
It's like the Amityville Horror. It's really cool. And the rest of the movie goes from there. You know, it's based on a true story. And like,
Icky.
I actually went online, and like BuzzFeed has a whole article about like what's factually accurate and what isn't and stuff.
Is it close?
It's very close.
Okay.
It's very close. And I went home, and like I'm like checking over my shoulder, and it's like this film got under my skin. There are shadows that I'm looking at. This movie really scared me.
No,
I kind of like, it's careful what you wish for. It's all I ever want in a scary movie is to be scared.
Oh, and there's children. Ick.
Oh.
Yeah, scary children. Scary possessed children.
They're sticky, and they're gross, and they're scary, and they're probably wearing white little dresses.
Whether you are a fan of horror or not, you have to see this movie because you have to see how well it's made. It should be at a film studies class somewhere.
Really?
It looks like it's directed by Steven Spielberg or Robert Zemeckis. It is a gorgeous film. The art direction, the production design, the screenplay, the director, the coloration. This movie is...
I will.
I will.
Okay.
No, it's just so good.
Okay, so this
see
is
it.
A see it. And if I see this one, I'm going to see it during the day.
She's even holding a rosary on the cover. I'm not seeing it.
Cover your eyes if you have to, but go and see this movie. It's so outstanding.
Singing. All right, you have a 2 giveaways and a movie club, so we've got to rip through it.
Right. Okay, Zootopia, new on Blu-ray and DVD
Zootopia.
This week. great. I love what Disney's doing. Their animation's so incredible, really great one. So go to my website to enter to win a free digital copy of this film. So that's my first giveaway.
I don't get it.
It's the kind you can download to iTunes or your phone.
Oh, I remember you talking about that.
Kind of thing.
Okay,
yeah,
got
it. Exactly. And then I have a giveaway for a Lucky Morning Blend viewer in honor of your birthday. It's a birthday movie starring Molly Ringwald.
Yeah.
16 Candles.
That's cute.
So somebody's going to win this Blu-ray. And it's not for you, but it's in your honor. It's in Molly's honor.
So could this show get any more about me?
How are we gonna do that? Caller number 16 wins 16 candles starring Molly Ringwald.
For Molly's birthday! 414-799-4444 is the number to call for that.
Yeah.
Molly might
really
even come watch it.
Big deal, big deal movie club.
Yeah,
Finding Dory. People are freaking out about this movie.
Oh, yeah.
Ellen.
It's Tuesday, June 14th at 7 p.m. Enter to win at my website.
Is Ellen DeGeneres the voice?
Yes. Of course she is.
She better be.
Cute.
Yeah.
Okay, June 14th.
So
you go for free. See it before everyone else. Bring your kids, and then they can brag about it.
Yeah.
Not in school, but to their friends.
You can like Ryan J on Facebook, follow him on Twitter, and for his full movie reviews, check out that website, ryanjreviews.com. Thanks, Ryan.
Thank you, too.
Great to see you.